Global Ethics Corner from the Carnegie Council.
The Middle Ages commonly saw the employment of Swiss guards and professional companies with specialized training. In the American Revolution, the British used Hessians, often conscripts sold into service who became an added insult. French foreign legionnaires were effective, paid volunteers incorporated directly into the military, not mercenaries. Mercenary suggests skilled, no-nonsense action, but also has an undertone of hired killers to whom only money matters. Today we call them private contractors, hired for tasks outside the capability or mission of a nation's civil and military personnel. Quote, according to the Congressional Research Service, contractors accounted for 48% of the Department of Defense workforce in Iraq and 57% in Afghanistan. End quote. A few were torturers. More frequently, they train, drive trucks, manage technology, or provide security. Often they are efficient specialists like the Swiss Guards, and their motives are more than money. However, one senior Afghani suggests that as little as 25% of aid actually hits the ground, the rest siphoned off by contracts and subcontracts. Legal corruption. Contractors are also not directly accountable. They report to private bosses, not ultimately to the American people. Finally, using contractors allows people and politicians to look away. Who sees the contractors' caskets come home? Neither their plunder nor sacrifice is in the national debate. To complete a difficult task, are contractors' specialized skills and political cover valuable? What about the hidden costs? What do you think? This is William Vokey from the Carnegie Council.
Made possible by the Carnegie Council for Ethics and International Affairs. Post a comment at www.carnegiecouncil.org.